Welcome to Music City RV. This is one of our rentals. It's a brand new 2023 Jayco 29F. And I'm gonna go through our video checkout, and so you can see exactly how everything functions and everything that's available in the RV. So we'll start on the outside. There's plenty storage on these Class A, so all of the compartments on this passenger side are completely available for any storage needs that you have while traveling. And both this compartment and the second compartment down have complete through storage all the way through. So if you have something like a surfboard or something like that you'd like to take with you along the way, there is room to do that. Also, each of these compartments has a light switch that's available to be turned on so you can see what you have in there. More storage here. This is where the propane and on this side, the only business end of this part of the RV is your propane. So this is your main propane valve, and you've got your propane gauge here. This will be used for running the heater, also used for running the refrigerator while you're traveling, and for using the stove and oven. When the gauge gets down to about a quarter, you'll need to make sure that you find somewhere to get it filled up. There's fill stations at most all of the KOA campgrounds, also some truck stops, and Tractor Supply also has availability to fill the propane, and that's filled right through here. Additional storage in here, of which we do provide four camp chairs, a camp table, and an awning mat that will go out underneath the awning, which we'll show you when we come back around. Last but not least, small storage there. Back of the RV has a ladder for checking your roof clearance, which is 12 foot 6 inches. You are able to climb up onto the ladder to check for clearance, but we do ask that you do not get up on the roof. They're not made for holding people. You have your trailer hitch here with a 7-pin wiring. If you would like to bring a bike rack or something along, those are perfect for that. But the towing capacity is pretty minimal on these RVs. Also on the back of the RV, you'll also have sewer pipe storage, which we'll show you how to use that shortly, but it is stored in this compartment here. One of the other things that's big about these Class A RVs is the fact that they have a lot of space behind the rear wheels. So it's something that when you're turning sharp corners, you're in a parking lot or near a gas station, you need to make sure that the rear corner passes by anything that you're next to before you start to make your turn. Otherwise, you will take out one of those big yellow poles they have by the gas pumps. On the passenger side, this is the side where the slide is. The slide on this particular RV, and all of our RVs actually go the whole length of the side to maximize the space inside when you have it out. But my biggest suggestion is you take care of all your business on the business side of this RV before you put the slide out. Otherwise, you'll be doing all of your work down here underneath the slide. So on this side, there is some additional storage, but all the tools and equipment are also over here. So this compartment is available for storage. This compartment has a power cord. So your power cord that you'll need to take and plug in for RV and shore power is right here. It is a 30 amp on this RV. The process for hooking this up: find your power pole at your campsite, make sure the breaker's turned off, run this over and plug it in, then turn the breaker for the power pole back on. We do provide an adapter if you happen to have a 50 amp service on your campsite, but it's in here for your use. We also provide surge protectors on all of our campers, so everything's automatic. There's about a 60 second delay once you turn the breaker on at the power pole before the RV will have power. This is where we store all of the leveling block pads, which we'll go through when we go through the leveling process of the RV. This is where you'll fill up the fuel as you're traveling around. This is where your black tank and your gray tank holding tanks are located in here. We'll come back to those in a second. We provide a bin with the necessary parts to keep your hands clean if needed, and a couple of adapters for the sewer line. So going back here to where the tank dumps are, there is a cap. You'll take this cap off. This adapter will go on to give you a little bit of flexibility on how you hook the hose up. Here, just like on your sewer pipe, you'll have claws on one end and pegs on the other. So the claws will hook onto the pegs under here. You can then go grab your sewer hose that was in the back bumper, and it connects onto this fitting like so, so you can keep an eye on what's coming out. I know it sounds a little bit gross, however, it is nice to be able to know that once you're dumping your tanks, that when they're finished, they're done and you can use the other one. The connections for both your gray water and your black water. So you can see on the gray handle here, this your gray water is your shower and sink water, and your black water is your, as I like to call it, the doo-doo water. Here's the fitting in which your hose will go. So this little cap comes off. You'll then take your sewer hose. You'll notice on the sewer hose that it has these little claws on one end and then these little spikes on the other. The claws will go onto the spikes on this here. And then you'll run this out to your either your sewer site on site or at the dump station where you dump. My suggestion and best practice for this is always dump the black lever first. That's your toilet water, let it come out. I generally then, once it's stopped, I close that off and flush some more water through the toilet, then come back out and dump it out. Then you can use the gray water to flush out all your lines and all your hoses. This is your fresh water and, hookup and your holding tank hookup. We do provide a pressure regulator for the water hose, and we do provide a water hose 20-foot length. And Jayco's done a really nice job of laying out how all of these valves work in order to get what you need and make water happen. So the idea is that you hook this end up to the water pole at your campground, run the other end up through the floor, like so. You can then hook this up to the pressure regulator, and if you're hooked up to city water, the water will flow when you turn the water on, with one exception. You do need to look here and see where it says city water. So if you follow the instructions, city water, the white valve is down, the blue valve is turned up, the green valve is this way, and the red valve is turned up like this. This will allow the city water to run from the pole right into the camper as you need. If you're dry camping, you follow the instructions for dry camping. And if you're looking to fill the tank, say you're leaving your campsite, planning to go stay somewhere where there's no water tomorrow, then you would want to turn the valves in this fashion so that the water will flow from the water spigot into the camper and fill the tank so you have water to use on the rest of your trip. Next compartment is again just storage. It's the pass-through from the other side in case you have long items. And then the last compartment is where your generator stores. You really shouldn't need to be in here or get in here for anything, but if for some reason you do overload the generator, if you're dry camping, there is a breaker switch in here that needs to be turned on. It should be on when you leave, but if for some reason you trip the breaker and you have no power with the generator running, this is the little button right here that you need to make sure is towards you. First part of the main panel of power, again, this is your main power switch that turns everything on. Your awning switch here. This is the solar system and charging system that's in the RV, which there shouldn't be anything you need to do. It does have an inverter, so you can run some things on 110 power while you're not plugged in or the generator's in. You've got interior lights here, your power step, which is automatically on, but you can lock it in and out based on using this switch. And then you've got your interior and exterior lights for under your awning and exterior light by the front door. So here's a full length awning. Of course, we talked earlier about the awning mat being able to be used for this, but this is the awning. This is one of those things that's amazing to have, but also the biggest and most damaged item on an RV. You need to watch for tree limbs while you're driving. You need to make sure that if you're not sitting under the RV, that you roll the RV in. So before you go to bed at night, get ready to go fishing or hiking with your family, make sure you roll the awning in, because these things are super, super expensive to repair and to replace. Also, while the awning's out, if you want to enjoy some time outside, there is an outdoor television on this particular model with a radio to use as well. So this is the driver's station of the Class A. You've got your leveling jack controls over on the left-hand side, along with power mirrors, and really everything you need to drive the coach as you travel around. Also over here are your accent lights for the front, your main lights for the cabin, and a shade for your privacy while parked in your campsite. Also, all of the side windows have blinds as well, so that you can keep what's inside in and what's outside out, allowing for privacy at night and so people can't see in while you have the lights on. So inside, the main controls are right here alongside the refrigerator. You have everything you need here to control everything inside the RV. Your generator hours are here. You also have your generator start and stop. There's a prime system for starting the generator. If it hasn't been started for a while, you can hold down the stop button and it will turn on the red light, and you hold it down for 3 or 4 seconds and then you can hit the start button. And then to stop it, just press stop here. With the generator running, the ACs will work, the refrigerator will work, and everything that you need to plug into inside will also work in the generator, whether you're plugged in or whether you're using the generator. You also have the extension for the slide, so the vehicle has to be turned off and the front door has to be open and the emergency brake has to be on, and you can just hit extend and it will then slide out this whole side of the RV, making your living space enormous inside. Water pump for fresh water. If you're boondocking or not hooked up to city water, you can turn it on here and you can actually turn it on outside. You also have your hot water heater switches here, so you can either work off of gas or electric. The gas is generally faster, but the electric is generally less expensive. You also have all of your gauges for all of your tanks here. So you have your propane tank, and if you look really closely, it lights up to tell you how much propane you have. Also your battery level, your fresh water level, your black water level, and your gray water level. Generally when these, especially the black water, gets to about 2/3, or your gray water gets to about 2/3, it's time to be trying to find somewhere to get those empty. You also have the controls for the inverter system, which there should be nothing you need to do with that, and your AC controls for the front air conditioner here, along with your accent lighting and your interior lights. So this bunk here is a convertible bed as well. You've got a little seatbelt latch to undo it here, and then you've got a key that needs to be turned on in order for the bed to come down. Oh, and the button's right here next to the key, and this will power the bed down while you're stationary, giving more room for your crew to sleep. Ladder attaches here so you can climb on. Dinette here that is also a convertible and can make a bed. So by lifting this, by moving the cushions and lifting this table out, the table will fold down, making this another bed for someone short to sleep. You also have a little bit of storage above the table area here. While you're stationary, there is a television here for the kiddos to watch while you're dining or relaxing. There is seating for 2 people on the couch and seat belts for 4 people in the dinette area, plus the 2 in the front. So you have 8 people that are available to travel in this RV. This couch is a scissor couch. If you fold up on this end and pull out and then push down, it does make another bed here. There's storage in these compartments. We've stocked the RV for you, so you've got your outdoor cooking gear. You've got extra sheets for these 2 convertible beds, and toaster storage up here. This particular RV has a oversized refrigerator and freezer for keeping all of your goods cold. This will run off of shore power, it will run off of generator power, and it will run off of propane. So you'll be able to keep all of your things cold anytime you're traveling. On the back side of the refrigerator, you have the kitchen with quite a bit of counter space, an oversized sink. We do provide a knife set, a water kettle, a coffee pot, cutting boards, and a drying rack for your use while you're traveling. So here's your 3-burner stove. Once your glass has been folded up, you can just turn any of the burner you want to the little flame and hit the striker and it'll light. You also have a 2-burner oven for use while you're traveling, and provided pots and pans. the back part of the RV, you'll see you've got two spacious bunk beds. These are great if you have little ones or an extra adult on your trip. Also, if you're not using them for sleeping arrangements, you do have the availability to put things in there for storage. So light switches on the opposite side of the bathroom. You have a sink along with some storage underneath here, a dinette, a place to put your toiletries. And one of my favorite things about these, in addition to the skylight, is the shower. This is an all glass shower, and it's a very spacious shower head there. So if you do have some little ones in, then you have the availability to get them. One of the biggest things with these doors is you need to make sure that while you're traveling that the doors are latched, because they are glass and they could break. You also have your toilet here. It's a pedal flush toilet. Water comes through in that way. We do provide marine or RV toilet paper for your journey as well. Through the bathroom, you can get through that side or this side. This goes back to the back bedroom. This is the queen bedroom. You have plenty of storage on this end, and then storage up on the top side as well. We do also provide bath towels and washcloths for your stay as well. As I mentioned earlier, all of the windows have shades, so you do have privacy. And all of the windows throughout the RV also open, so if it is nice out, you can get fresh air in as you go. This back bedroom also has availability to have some privacy. You just detach these little rubber cords here, and you have doors that close off the bathroom and the bedroom. Again, one other thing about while you're traveling, please just make sure that these cords are attached. Otherwise, the doors will slide open and close and come off of the hinge. So once you're in your campsite, once you've made sure that you have availability to water and power, and you've taken the orange jack pads that I showed you earlier and placed those underneath the jacks, this is the leveling system for the power jack. So basically you just turn on the power button, you hit the auto level button, and it starts to beep and tells you what you need to do. So the biggest things with this, you have to make sure the emergency brake is turned on and that the engine is not running, and the jacks will do their thing.